Hello, Fleetwood Area School District families. This is Dr. Little, the principal at the middle school, and I'm here to tell you about scheduling for the 2020-21 school year. We're excited to have your fifth graders come to us, and I wanted to give you some more information about the process that we need to complete before the summer happens. I just want to let you know our school focus next year is to working on enhance and build on the multi-tiered system support for all students, and we do this through our target time, which is similar to target time at the elementary schools. We're looking to support all students and increase core instructional support through that entire time. We also want to expose all of our students to the career pathways throughout their middle school career. And now we'll watch a short video made by some of our Fleetwood Middle School students about the middle school.
After this summer. It is grades 5 through 8 and there is about 800 students that go here. This is the entrance of the middle school where the main office is and you will see our school security monitor. This school was first a smaller building and then they built an add-on to it to make it the building it is today. The first time it was built was in 1967. This is where all the buses come in the morning and afternoon. You can come out the guidance entrance or the main office entrance. This is the entrance where the fifth graders would mainly come into school on a daily basis. You will also leave the school through these doors. When you walk in, you will see the bell in the guidance office. Here are the doors that you will use to go to recess, and there is some equipment for recess that you can use, or you can bring your own. This is where you will have recess every day unless it rains. There are basketball courts, tetherball, foursquare, a soccer field, and many trees. At recess, you can play football, or most people play tag here. This is behind the tree line by the softball field. During recess, you can play kickball here. There is a set of bleachers that you can sit on if you want to watch instead. This is by the soccer field behind the tree line. During recess, you can play soccer and other sports in the open area next to the softball field. These are the doors you will use to go to the field hockey fields for gym. If you are in the 7-8 gym, you will come out of these doors. They are right next to the stadium. This is where you can go for gym when you go outside for outdoor activities. You will do different runs and warm-ups on the track. You come here for gym and play outdoor activities. You also may warm up here before you start the activities. You can use Pride cards, almost like Pub Club coupons or Crowd Paws, to eat lunch here with a friend. This is the 5-6 gym across from the band room. In this class, you do many things, including fitness. This is where you will have gym sometimes, and you will have gym here in the 7th and 8th grade. Some of the things you will do in here are volleyball, crazy kickball, and gym activities. This is beside the orchestra room.
Right, students may enter the building at 7:55 a.m. That's when our doors open up, and they report directly to their homeroom. They need to be in their homeroom by 8:10 a.m. in the morning, and if they arrive after 8:10 in the morning, they're considered tardy, and they have to go to the office to sign in. During homeroom, students can go to breakfast, and at 3:05 p.m., students will be dismissed to return back to their homeroom to pack up. In fifth grade, we'll have four teams of two teachers. We'll have a red team, a white team, a black team, and a gray team. Each teacher will teach math or language arts and science or social studies. In fifth grade, students will have seven periods throughout the day. They'll have a period and a half of language arts, a period and a half of math, a social studies and science period, where the class is held every other day, a target time every day, which is similar to target time at the elementary level, physical education and health, which runs every other day all year, and then other electives. There is also a homeroom, a recess, and a lunch that are all on the schedule, but they're not as periods. And this is not the exact order of how it will be on the student schedule. So some of our classes in the middle school, science class, in fifth grade they do general science topics. In sixth grade they'll do earth science, seventh grade will be life science, and eighth grade will be physical science. And students do take a science PSSA based on the fifth and eighth grade, through eighth grade material at the end of their eighth grade year. Socialized classes at the middle school, fifth grade does American history and geography, sixth grade does geography in Latin America, seventh grade does early civilization, and eighth grade does American history and geography. For fifth grade math, the students learn about fractions, decimals, geometry, measurement and data, place value, and coordinate grids. And they do have a math PSSA at the end of the year. For language arts, students do reading and writing in the language arts periods. They read Wonder and also the one and only Ivan. And they will have a language arts PSSA at the end of the year. So each year, students will have the opportunity to select electives. During fifth grade, they have two required classes that every fifth grader must take. Elective choices are never guaranteed unless students pick band, chorus, orchestra. Those are always guaranteed electives through fifth through eighth grade. So we offer electives in two ways. There's 45-day electives, which run every other day for a semester, which is two marking periods. So they would have their elective on odd day or even day, or marking period 1, 2, or marking period 3 and 4. And this is a lot of our electives throughout the middle school in 5th through 8th grade. There's also 90-day electives, which are for an entire school year every other day. So those include band, chorus, orchestra. So if the student's in band, they'll have band on odd days all throughout the school year. Or they'll have chorus on even days all throughout the school year. We did a lot of work with our electives this year, looking at the career pathways and how our electives align to the career pathways that we're focusing on. If you have this presentation later, you can click on this career pathways video, and it talks a lot more about the work that the BCIU has done with the career pathways. The five career pathways that the middle school is using are engineering, industrial technology, human services, arts and communication, business, finance, and information technology, and science and health. The two required fifth grade electives for all students is going to be Digital Tigers, which looks like Google. Our school does a lot of Google applications. We work with Google Education. Most of the teachers have a Google Classroom, so that's helping the students prepare for that throughout the school year. We also have a class this year called Fifth Grade Advisory, and this is going to help students be successful in their middle school career and looking at strategies and other classes for future success. Those two are required for all fifth grade students. Students can also take band, chorus, and orchestra in fifth grade. These are 90 days again, every other day all year. You can take one or all three. They're during the same period of the day. So you'll participate in winter and spring concerts and pasta and presto as well. Like I said, these are going to run every other day. So band will run 3 days out of a six-day cycle. Orchestra will run 3 days out of a six-day cycle. And chorus will also run 3 days out of a six-day cycle. Other fifth grade electives we have that are 45 days, so they're half a year every other day. So the students would have the electives on the odd days or the even days for the first and second marking period or the third and fourth marking period. There's art through time, where students will learn art history and create their own work, where they have to have some pieces of art in the art show. A music class for those students that aren't in band, chorus, or orchestra to explore how to make instruments and the different types of music. Imagineering, which is the STEM-based course where students are introduced to engineering, design, and process. And then Full Steam Ahead, which explores the many aspects of science, technology, engineering, arts, and math, and how they're interconnected. Also in schedules, you might see ETC or resource. ETC is for students with a GIEP, and they focus on their GIEP goals. If they have an IEP, they will have a resource class possibly on their schedule, and it's going to focus on working on their IEP goals. This year during fifth grade, you're going to schedule using Home Access Center. And this will let us know whether you want to be participating in band, chorus, orchestra, and what the other electives you might want to take. However, if you don't take band, chorus, orchestra, you'll just have all six electives that are offered. This video here, this link on this presentation, will show you actually how to do the scheduling in Home Access Center. You cannot do it as a parent. You have to go through your student account. So students must use their username and password. If you don't know that, there's contacts in the following slides that will show you who to contact for that. There's just five simple steps to schedule on Home Access Center. It's pretty easy. Students usually takes about 5 to 10 minutes to do. So if you don't know your student's Home Access account, you're going to contact these individuals. They may be sending you an email already as we start the scheduling process. However, if you have any questions, you can always email me about the electives or the process or the schedule at nlytle@fleetwoodasu.org. If you're currently in fourth grade with the last name A through I, you will get an email from Kathy Carpuke, or you're going to email her if you haven't heard from her. In fourth grade with last names J through R, you're going to contact Janine Bayshore. She's our guidance secretary, or she'll email you for the username and password. And last names S through Z is going to be Miss Kaylee in the main office, and you're going to contact her if you don't have your username and account for Home Access Center for your student. Other things at the middle school, we have homework pages. This is where all our daily homework assignments are posted. It's sorted by grade and team on the Fleetwood Area School District website under middle school. The homework assignments are listed under the quick links. You'll just click that link there, and it'll take you to a series of Google Docs that'll show you the homework assignments for your student. This is a short little video clip about our Pride program made by a few of our students and one of our teachers.
Here we see Cameron and Maggie making their way into the school. Even though they are both very excited to learn, they are being very respectful and not crowding the doorway. These two must first make their way to their lockers to get the right materials for their day. That's an organized locker there, Cameron. They both make sure to lock their lockers and off to start this dandy of a day. When walking through the hallway, they stay on the right side, the same way drivers do on the road. Oh, hey, Miss Marsden. Maggie and Cameron get right to business by getting out what they need for class. That's being prepared. Sometimes, well, nature calls. And when it does, fill out your agenda and have your teacher sign it. Your agenda becomes your hall pass. Neato! When using the lavatory, make sure not to dilly-dally. You're missing valuable class time. Place your agenda in the holder outside the bathroom. Then, flush, wash, and go. And go. Ah, there we are. Make sure you head directly back to class. Ah, lunch. A time to socialize, recharge, and have a healthy meal. Way to push your chair in, Maggie. That shows integrity. The girls patiently wait their turn to get their lunch while they pick up their utensils. When lunch is finished, they wait to be called to throw out any rubbish and return their trays. Now these trays are empty because this is a demonstration. Even though the day is over, the girls still show they have tiger pride by making the right decisions, even outside of school. Thank you.
a pride program. We have these things called pride cards, which is in the right-hand corner here. Students can earn those throughout the school day. The gold ones are worth 2, and the pink ones are worth 1. They can turn those in for prizes that we have during lunches. Students can also earn a prideful referral, which is one of our positive referrals. So when a student gets a prideful referral, Mr. Hanrahan or myself actually calls home and lets the parents know, and then the students get a copy of it with some pride cards. We also have outstanding students, where students can earn all the pride prizes each marking period if they get high honor roll, no discipline referrals, and they're here every day. So lunch is the computer debit system, just like at the elementary level. There is breakfast during homeroom. It's about 20 minutes long. If students want that, they can go down the cafeteria. And for lunch, 5th and 6th graders are assigned by table by homeroom. Agendas. So all the students get agendas the first day. There's lots of useful information in the agenda with websites we're using. It's also their pass throughout the day. So if they want to go to the restroom, go to the main office, or they need to go to the school counselor, they will use their agenda to go places. We also have assignment center after school. It's kind of like homework club. Mondays through Thursdays, 3:15 to 4:15. For extra help with homework, teachers run it. It's in the LGN library. There's this permission slip to fill out to have your student attend assignment center. This is a short video clip about our library made by some of our students.
Welcome to Fleetwood Middle School's library. It was established in 1967. These are the comics and new books, the fiction books, the nonfiction books, and the magazines.
The atlas and dictionaries are located by the front of the room. You can use them if you ask for permission. These books are paperbacks.
You can find what kind of books we have in our library here. All you need to do is look at the sticker and you can see what category the book is in.
Students and teachers can check out library books and they can renew books if they need to here. This is where you can return books quick and easy by dropping them in the slot.
Digital citizenship lessons are taught here. In digital citizenship, you learn how to be healthy and safe on the internet. This screen is used to present our lessons and assignments during digital citizenship lessons.
Here is the outside walls of the library. Sometimes student artwork is hung here. This is where the library is, near the main entrance and the 8th grade hallway.
The map shows the fastest route out of the library in case of an emergency.
Well, it depends on the book. If it's a reference book, you can have it for 1 week. All the other books are for 3 weeks. You have to go up to the circulation desk and either myself or a library aide would be there. We will ask you for your student ID number. We type it in and we scan the books and stamp them and then you're all set. Well, there is a limit in the computer, but I don't follow the limit. I let you renew a book as many times as you want unless somebody else is waiting for the book. Fifth graders may have 3 books at one time, and 6th, 7th, and 8th graders may have 5 books at one time. You have to go to the Destiny page in your favorites, and you click on that, and then you click on catalog, and then you can search by title, author, subject, or series. Well, the symbols on the books tell you like what different kinds of books they are, like if it's a fantasy book or a mystery book or something like that. You just come into the library and say, I need a Chromebook, and then you sign it out on the clipboard and you take it.
Here is the course selection in the packet, online. You don't need to print this out. You could definitely could just look at it and then write notes out on a piece of paper. The first page is kind of an introduction letter. It kind of explains the scheduling process as well. There's a scheduling video here you can click on, which will show you the video you're watching actually now. This video here is going to show you how to actually go on home access and put your courses in. This link right here is the advanced application. These are the people you're going to contact if you don't know your student's home access account information, the username and password. The second page is just you putting down, you know, your student name, parent names. This is more information about scheduling. Like I said, you don't have to print this out. If you do this online, we don't need to get a paper copy back. Down below, it's going to give you the electives for students. So if you go through, you'll see the course name here, the grade level of who can take it, which career pathway it falls under, and then a short description as well. For each course, make sure you look at the grade level, because if you're picking courses that are not in your grade level, they're not going to appear on Home Access Center. We typically have an open house before school starts. It's usually the Thursday before, so it's Thursday, August 27th, tentatively. You can meet the teachers, they'll be there that night. You can get the student locker combination and lock to practice, fill out school forms, and there's also a fair held in the gym where there's multiple tables of information about food services, athletics, SAP, the Karen Foundation. We also have some social media pages on Twitter, Facebook, and Instagram. We also have a student council Instagram at this time, so those are the usernames to follow us at. And contact information for myself and my assistant principal. Our school phone number is 610-944-7634. Right now, my district cell phone is 610-587-7058, and it's nlytle@fleetwoodasc.org. And then Mr. Handerhan's email is khanderhan@fleetwoodasc.org. If you have any questions, please give us a call or shoot us an email. Let us know. We are excited for your kids to come here next year.